Good crowd in the sunshine, maybe a little apprehensive, maybe a little curious, trying to figure out what SC is going to look like this year. Jim Watson, Yogi Roth upstairs down on the field. They begin the spring showcase with a pursuit drill. And we're joined by the head coach, Clay Helton, now in his fourth full season as the head guy. But Clay, you've been on campus, what, 2010? So Yogi's up here explaining the air raid offense to me, yeah, talking about based on four verticals.
Yeah.
Have you ever been around it? Do you understand it? Do you know how it works yet?
Well, I tell you, I felt in the last couple games when, you know, we really started to sling the ball around a little bit and made some things simpler for our kids, that's what we wanted to be able to go to with the weapons that we had. And the nature of the offense is simplicity, to take the thought process away, you know, from the kids where they don't have to think so much and they can just play. And they're playing so fast right now. From practice one to practice 12, it has been fun to watch. A lot of balls flying, a lot of kids getting the ball in their hands, and obviously we have some special playmakers to be able to do that.
Coach, anyone who's been around the air raid says, wow, imagine if it was at a place like USC with the athletes that you guys have. What about this system with these players, with the space that you just referenced, gives you so much confidence after 12 practices here in spring football?
Yeah, I've always been fascinated, you know, if you took a team of USC Trojan football players within this system, what could it do? And then to bring in Graham Harrell and to be able to institute that and see the energy that it brings and how fast our kids are playing. Man, I wish we could play next week, to be honest with you. Really excited to get the season here.
Coach, you ever just wail on somebody with that bag right
yeah.
there?
This is I let out right some there. Frustration on the guys every now and then, but it's good to give them a little physical and visual distraction while they're having to make all these catches.
Oh, I love it. So something I've noticed being at spring practice, been about 7-8 of them throughout the spring here, the excitement around your program. Talked to JT Daniels the other day, and he said Graham Harrell has this quote, which is, the most excited team wins. And yep. I feel as though that has become a mantra for your program. Yes, talk about that, and what have you noticed being around this team since the season ended until now around that?
Yeah, there's a great energy and so much fun happening right now. Even with us as a coaching staff, we're having a blast with these kids. And, you know, I credit Graham and the staff right now for the job they're doing. I mean, they have made it a ton of fun for these kids, and we're all having a blast as coaches, as players, as a team. So it's been a great spring.
Clay, one of the things you did, besides bringing in these five or six different new coaches, and there's new assignments, including mm-hmm. yourself. So now you talked about the turnovers, the penalties, the mistakes yeah. last year that killed drives so yeah. many times. And you've given yourself a new role on this team, handling discipline. What does yeah. that mean, and why did you do it?
Yeah, you know, when I looked at us at the last four losses, we lost four games by 7 points or less. And I studied the film. I must have watched the games 100 times. And I came to the conclusion that we beat ourselves. We beat ourselves because turning the ball over. We beat ourselves with the discipline of the game when it came to penalties. And we beat ourselves because we lost fundamental and techniques that are key to winning football games. So that was my discipline this spring, was to get away from the schemes and the X's and O's. From a head coach standpoint, I hired three great coordinators in Clancy and Graham and Coach Baxter. Let them run our three phases, implement scheme, and let me focus on what really matters to win football games, and that's the discipline of the game, making it a sense of urgency about all about the ball when it comes to turnovers and ball security, and then getting back to just doing the little things better. Simplifying the scheme and let it be about you getting better fundamentally and technique-wise rather than trying to beat somebody with the scheme. Beat them with fundamentals and technique.
Coach, last year you started a quarterback who missed his senior year of high school. Where has JT Daniels evolved? Has he thrived in this system now being on campus and just maturing as a college student athlete for now a full year?
Yeah, you know, I think all four quarterbacks that are competing in this thing have really done a nice job of picking up the system and really being decisive, you know, with their decisions. You know, in this offense, you get five out a bunch, and you have so many options to be able to throw to. And the offense is about making the quick decision and releasing the ball. And each one of them have done a great job of that this camp. I think it's helped JT grow as well as Matt and Jack. And even Keenan Slovis, who hasn't been to the prom yet, he's supposed to go here in about a month. He's thriving in it as a true freshman. So, you know, it's been a lot of fun to watch with those four kids and how they've progressed.
Clay, I still never been to my prom, never got out. I think I had to work that night. Hey, man, this is great. Look, it's football, it's sunny, it's the middle of campus. You got the spirit of Troy behind you. Any place you'd rather be right now?
How about Art Bartner? 50 years.
Last year, right? Art Bartner, the director of the spirit of Troy?
Yeah, we want to be able to give him a special memory this year.
Maybe you can gray shirt him and get him to come back in
the year. I would love it. I'll take him as long as he's got eligibility and wants to do it.
Hey, Clay, can't thank you enough for the time. I know you're a busy man. Everybody in this town wants to talk to you. We're going to let you get back to work. Appreciate it. Best of luck this year.
Thanks, guys. Take care.
Clay Helton, who is 24-10 against Pac-12 opponents. And how about this, at the Coliseum, 19-3.